إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الكلام كلام الله عز وجل وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. My dear brothers and sisters, today inshaAllah ta'ala we will talk about a great hadith. The hadith that was narrated or collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim and also narrated by many other scholars of hadith, which is the hadith of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن الصدق يهدي إلى البر وإن البر والبر يهدي إلى الجنة وإن الرجل ليصدق حتى يكتب عند الله صديقا and then he said وإن الكذب يهدي إلى الفجور وَإِنَّ الْفُجُورَ يَهْدِي إِلَى النَّارِ وَإِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيَكْذِبُ حَتَّى يُكْتَبَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَذَّابًا وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ So in this hadith, my dear brothers and sisters, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is describing two opposite things, which is as-sidq, truthfulness, and lie, al-kadhib. So, and he's describing the benefit of as-sidq and the ending of as-sidq and also the harm and the bad characteristic of al-kadhib or a lie and the ending of the lie. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, which is we start with the meaning, he said, for sure, truthfulness, as-sidq, saying the truth, being truthful, it leads to righteousness. Righteousness is when someone knows what to do, only the right things. You be a righteous person. If you say the truth, so then you be a righteous person. When birru, which is أعمال الخير كلها, all the good deeds are called a birr also. يهدي إلى الجنة. It leads to paradise. And then he said, and the man is still talking and saying the truth and investigating the truth till he will be written before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be a truthful one, a siddiq, which is a level that is just after the prophets. My dear brothers and sisters, so let's talk about first about a siddiq, which is truthfulness. As-sidq, my dear brothers and sisters, is that if one of us should say what is or what he thinks is true, so that's the truth or the truthfulness. If one of us, when he say what he thinks is true and that matches with the reality without any addition, or shortening from the reality, from all what is happening. So this is pretty general about definition of the truth or a simple truthfulness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised and he commanded also the believer to to be among the truthful people, the truthful one. He said in Surah Tawbah, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, all you who believe, ittaqu Allah, fear Allah, wa kunu ma'a as-sadiqin, and be with the truthful one. Ibn Kathir alayhi rahmatullah, when he mentioned this ayah, and then he said, Al-Isdiqu wal-zimu al-sidq. Me be truthful and stick on the truthfulness. Takunu min ahli. You will be among the truthful one. And watanju min al-mahaliki wa yaj'al lakum farajan fi umurikum wa makhraja. And then you will be saved from hardship or the troubles. Wa yaj'al lakum faraja. And that Allah will make for you an opening in all your matters, and He will open for you exit for all your trouble and hardship. So this is one of the results of being with the truthful one and being a truthful person. Being truthful, my dear brothers and sisters, we lead at the end to the highest rank, as we said, which is the as-siddiqiyya, meaning the truthworthiness. Someone who is a Siddiq, my dear brothers and sisters, is someone that is just under the Prophet. If we are saying the truth in all our saying, when we deal with people and we investigate to be truthful all the time, so then maybe one day we will be reaching that level which is a Siddiq. As we know, Abu Bakr Siddiq, he's called a Siddiq. Why? Because he reaches that level. And then many men reaches the level of Siddiq. Besides prophets, prophets are the highest rank of the human being. And a Siddiq also could happen, woman could be a Siddiq. As Allah said about Maryam alayhi salam, وَأُمُّهُ صِدِّيقَةٌ كَانَ يَأْكُلَانِ الطَّعَامِ. So that one of us could be a Siddiq just by being truthful and being sincere when he's dealing with people and being a truthful person all the time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Nisa, describing the four categories of the good people, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow His grace and His ni'mat on them. He said, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولُ, whoever obey Allah and His Messenger, فَأُولَٰئِكَ, those they will be مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. So in this ayah we see that the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide them, and then the people that when we pray and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us the sweet path, we're asking Allah to guide us the path of those four categories of people. The first one, an-nabiyyin. No one could be nabi now. The last prophet is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But we can be a truthful one if we want. So by saying the truth and investigating the truth and nothing except the truth. So this is the highest position which is after the Prophet. Also, the Prophet, the truthful one, my dear brothers and sisters, is the one who is known by being truthful, is well respected by the people. He's the one that is trusted by people. He's the one that is in high rank within the society. That's the one, the most important things of being truthful. Ibn Hibban alayhi rahmatullah, one of the scholars of Hadith, the great scholar, he said, As-Sidqu, he said it in his book, Rawdatul Uqala, he said, As-Sidqu yabra'u mar'a bidarain. That truthfulness will raise the one who is truthful. By saying the truth, by being truthful in the two lives, in this dunya and in the akhirah. He said, كَمَا إِنَّ الْكَذِبَ يَهْوِي بِهِ فِي الْحَدِيثِ. It's like also the same, the lying or lying will throw him away. We throw him away or very down and very low in these two lives. In this dunya and also in the Akhirah, because of the punishment that he deserved because of his life. And then he said, وَلَوْ لَمْ يَكُنْ الصِّدْقُ خَصْبَةً تُحْمَدْ. He said, إِلَّا أَنَّ الْمَرْأَ إِذَا عُرِفَ بِهِ قُبِلَ كَذِبُ. He said, if the truthfulness, it wasn't praise characteristic, it wasn't a good characteristic, so except a person who is having the characteristic of being truthful, so then his life will be accepted as a truth. Why? Because he's known to be truthful. He said, Ibn Hibban, وَصَارَ صِدْقًا عِنْدَ مَنْ يَسْمَعُ. Like, his life even will be accepted as truthful, as truth thing, a truth saying. So he said, Ibn Hibban, لَكَانَ الْوَاجِبُ عَلَى الْعَاقِلِ أَنْ يَبْلُغَ مَجْهُودَهُ فِي رِيَاضَةِ إِنْسَانِهِ حَتَّى يَسْتَقِيمَ لَهُ عَلَى الصِّدْقِ وَمُجَانَبَةِ الْكَذِبِ. He said, Ibn Hibban, it will be enough for a person, for the wise one, the one who is smart, that he should get a sit by training himself and his tongue to say only the truth and to avoid lying, till his tongue will be straight upon saying the truth only. So that's the saying of Ibn Hibban alayhi rahmatullah. Also Al-Sha'bi, Al-Imam Al-Sha'bi alayhi rahmatullah, he said, talking about truthfulness, which is a sidq, he said, عَلَيْكَ بِالصِّدْقِ حَيْتُ تَرَى أَنَّهُ يَضُرُّ. He said, observe truthfulness when you see it harm you. فَإِنَّهُ يَنْفَعُ. It will benefit you. Even you see that it will harm you, but it will benefit you. And then he said, وَاجْتَنِبِ الْكَذِبِ. And avoid lying. حَيْتُ تَرَى أَنَّهُ يَنْفَعُ. Avoid lying even you see that benefit you when you lie. He said, فَإِنَّهُ يَضُرُّ. And the lie will harm you. So that's the saying of Al-Imam Al-Sha'bi about the truthfulness and the lie itself. So my brothers and sisters, if you want to be respected, if you want to be honored in among the society, among the community, he said, and also if you want to be trusted, if you want to be brave, because when you say truth all the time, the fear will not be close to you at all. That's one of the benefits of truthfulness. If you want to be a righteous person, by your brothers and sisters, if you want to enter paradise, so then عليكم بالصدق. هذا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده. الصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم after that he said, talking about lie or the lie, he said, وَإِنَّ الْكَذِبَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْفُجُورِ. And it's for sure or certainly that lie will lead to weakness and will lead to evil doing, to transgression. He said, وَالْفُجُورُ. And weakness will lead to hellfire. وَالْفُجُورُ يَهْدِي إِلَى النَّارِ. وَإِنَّ الرَّجُلَ. And also a man, لَيَكْذِبُ حَتَّى يَكْتَبَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَذَّابًا وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. And then he said, a man will keep saying lies, lies after lies, till he will be written before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be a liar. He will be given a certificate that he is a liar, كَذَّابًا وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. So that's very serious matter. So lying is a characteristic or a character that is not good at all, my brothers and sisters. People will reject your saying. People will not trust you. That's the result of lying. One time, two times, people will put you among the hypocrites. Because Rasulullah said, lies is one of the characteristics or the sign of the hypocrites, as he said in the hadith. The sign of the hypocrites are three. The first of these characteristics is one, إِذَا حَدَّثَ كَذَا. When he talks, when he has conversation, he lies. So, people will not look at you in a good way at all. that's one of the harm or the harm that could comes from the lie when we lie. The true believer, my dear brothers and sisters, is not a liar at all. And he cannot be a liar. The true believer, he cannot be a liar. Because it is, as we said, it's a characteristic of the hypocrites. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَكَذِبُونَ. Allah is a witness that the hypocrites are the ones who are a liar. Not the believer, not the mu'minin. And also he described them in Surah Al-Baqarah, when he described the second category or the third category of people, he said, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ. In their heart there is a disease. فَزَادَهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا. And that Allah has more disease on their hearts. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ. And they will have a harsh or a hard torment, a punishment in the day of judgment. Why? بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ. Because they used to be lying. So this is the characteristic of the hypocrites, my dear brothers and sisters. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, he said, إِنَّمَا يَفْتَرِي الْكَذِبَ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. And this is the one who produced life, they are the one who doesn't believe. بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَاذِبُونَ. That is, لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ, they don't believe in the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those, they are the one who are a liar. That's in Surah An-Nahl. Also, my dear brothers and sisters, we have to know that the liar, he reverses the reality, the things that you see. He reverses the thing that is far away. He will describe it to you that is very close. He will describe things that are far, that are close, and he describes to you as they are very far away. Because this is how he is lying. And also, he makes someone that is good, he made it bad. And you see him, you see that who is good, that he is bad. So this we go from the lying. Al-Shaykh or Al-Alim Al-Mawidi Ali Rahmatullah, he said, talking about the consequence and the results and the end of Al-Kadhib, he said, وَالْكَذِبُ جِمَاعُ كُلِّ شَرٍ. Talking about lying. Al-Kadhib is gathering of every evil. He said, وَأَصْلُ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ. And it's the base of every sin. Something that is not good at all. لِسُوءِ عَاقِبَةٍ. Because of the bad ending of it. وَخُوْفِ نَتَائِهِ. And the evil of his results. لِأَنَّهُ يُنْتِجُ النَّمِيمَةً. Because it results, the lying, the result, slandering, namima between people. وَالنَّمِيمَةُ تُنْتِجُ الْبَغْضَاءُ. And slandering will produce hatred. And then وَالْبَغْضَاءُ and hatred will produce الْعَدَاوَة, which is enmity. Enmity. And then he said, وَلَيْسَ مَعَ الْعَدَاوَةِ أَمْنُ وَلَغَاءُ. And because of that, at the end, with the enmity, there is no safety and there is no rest at all. So the one who is involved in it, because of life, so then there is no safety at all and there is no rest. He's not so brilliant in his life at all. And then he said, وَلِذَٰلِكَ قِيلَ مَنْ قَلَّ صِدْقُهُ قَلَّ صَدِيقُهُ. That's the saying of Al-Bawardi. He said, because of that, he was said, whoever he has few amount of truthfulness, so that he will have a few friends. Why? Because everybody will be going away from him. That's the saying of Al-Bawardi Al-Abdullah. One of the wise people, he said, that's from a long time ago, he said, Al-Kadhabu Nissun. The liar is a thief. He said, لِأَنَّ الْلِصَّ يَسْرِقُ مَالِهِ. Because the thief, he will steal your wealth, he steal your money. And then he said, وَالْكَذَّابُ يَسْرِقُ عَقْلَكَ. And then the liar, he steal your mind. As we see, the media, all lying, they steal the mind of people. They can direct the opinion of people from one direction to another direction. So this is because of the liar. So that's the meaning of it. The liar is a thief that steals your mind. Also, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, alayhi rahmatullah, he used to, as we know, he ruled 2 years and in his time, like the safety and piety in the world, the Muslim world, was to be in its maximum. Like he could come back to the time of Khilaf. He said, when sending a letter to his one of his agents, and the Muslim state, when it used to be a big and country, the Muslim state. So he said to him, Iyaka and Tastareen and Tanoon. Beware or be careful that you're going to ask support or help from a liar. He said, فَإِنَّكَ إِن تُطِعِ الْكَذُوبَ تَهْلَكَ. Look at this. That pious ruler is giving advice to another leader, one of his agents. Be careful, beware of using a liar in your work. He said, if you follow a liar, if you obey a liar, so then you will be destroyed. This is how they look at it. So, as we see during this time, my dear brothers and sisters, the lies are everywhere. In the deen, in between us as Muslims, we should stay away from lies. We should be working and investigating truthfulness in all our deeds, in all our actions, our saying. And there is a hadith, Rasulullah said, I think it's from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, that from the sign of the Day of Judgment, he said, وَيَقْفِرُ الْكَبِيرُ. And then lies will be well spread all over the world. A lot of lies more than truthfulness. At the time of the Kufar, before Rasulullah, there is a hadith, Abu Sufyan radiallahu anhu, when he used to be a captain, he went to the Herculus, the king of the Roman at the time. So then he invited him, he wanted to ask him about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he heard about a new prophet coming. So then he was asking him questions. Abu Sufyan, he used to be the enemy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but he didn't lie. What he said in the authentic hadith, he said, I was scared and have shyness that the Arabs would talk about me that I am a liar. This is a character. So what about us Muslims? So we should work and avoid lying. Very bad characteristic as we talk about it. And there is many aspects of life that are happening in our life. The first and the worst of it, we're just going to mention it quickly, inshallah ta'ala, al-kadhibu ala Allahi wa rasulih. The worst of the things that someone lies on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَا تَصِفُ أَلْسِنَتُكُمُ الْكَذِبَ هَذَا حَلَالٌ وَهَذَا حَرَامٌ لِتَفْتَرُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ الْكَذِبَ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَفْتَرُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ الْكَذِبَ لَا يُفْلِحُونَ. That's in Surah An-Nahl, we said this ayah before. And the people who say about certain things that are halal or haram, against what is in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So those are the lying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the one who makes the fatwa without any knowledge, we have to be very careful. So this is lying also. Also, what is considered to be from the major sins, it's lying on about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Someone comes and he says, this is a sunnah, and it's not a sunnah. Someone comes and says, Rasulullah said, and he didn't say it. Rasulullah said, he warned the person like that, and he said, مَنْ كَذَبَ عَلَيَّ مُتَعَمِّنًا whoever lies for a lie on me by purpose, فَلْيَتَبَوَّأْ مَقْعَدَهُ مِنْ اللَّهِ. So let him predict, let him assume his spot in the hellfire. So that's number one. Number two is one of the aspects of lying when we trade, when we buy and sell. You have to buy, you want to sell it, and then you're not going to say the truth about it. Why? Because you want the money, you want the highest price. A believer, he doesn't give his akhirah with his dunya. Also, al-kadhibu, the irshadi that we learn, like lying to corrupt between people. Some people, when they see people, they love each other, there is harmony between them, so there is jealousy and envy, so they start making lies on that person. And then at the end, they will not relax till they see enmity between those people. What are you doing? Between wife and husband. And it happened, and I'm sure that we know a lot of stories about what's happening. And then the last one that we mentioned is many other, which is Al-Kadhibu Lil Harbi Sabini. There is a hadith of Rasulullah said, someone who lies is a joke. Lie. I mean, people laugh. A lot of people think, especially the youth, that it is normal. Rasulullah said in the hadith, وَيْلٌ لِلَّذِي يُحَدِّثُ فَيَكْذِبُ. Woe on the one that will talk, who have speech, and then he lies. He said, لِيُضْحِكَ بِهِ الْقَوْمِ. To make people laugh. وَيْلٌ لَهُ ثُمَّ وَيْلٌ لَهُ. Woe on him, and then woe on you. The last thing, my dear brothers and sisters, sorry, I said, which is the most important, and Al-Kadhibu, which is lying on our children. We shouldn't lie. Someone is calling home and then tell him he's not here. No. You are teaching your son to be a liar. You just talk, I don't have time. I cannot talk to you, that's it. No problem. As we said, عَلَيْكَ بِالصِّدْقِ حَيْثُ ظَهَرَ أَنَّهُ يَضُرُّ فَإِنَّهُ يَنْفَعُ. As we said from the wise people, we said that. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا وارحمنا وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اجعلنا من الصادقين. اللهم اجعلنا من الصادقين. اللهم اجعلنا من الصادقين. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق والشقاق يا رحمن يا رحيم. اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهتدين. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا يا رحمن يا رحيم. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا. اللهم ارحمنا وارحم موتانا يا رحمن يا رحيم. اللهم انصر ضعيفنا يا رحمن يا رحيم. واخذل اعداءنا يا عزيز يا كريم يا قوي يا عظيم. اللهم يا رحمن يا رحيم نسألك بكل اسم سميت به نفسك او انزلته في كتابك او علمته احدا من خلقك ان تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا. اللهم انا نسألك ان تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا. اللهم انا نسألك ان تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا يا رحمن يا رحيم. اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا وارحمنا وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم انصر اخواننا في فلسطين. اللهم انصر اخواننا في بورما. اللهم انصر اخواننا في سوريا وفرج كربتهم يا رحمن يا رحيم. اللهم عافنا واعف عنا وقنا عذاب النار. اقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه انه هو الغفور الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد. عبد الله اقم الصلاه.
أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على السلام. حي على الفلاح. قد قامت السلام. قد قامت السلام. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
معتمين وتراث الدين دقات تيكس فرطان في Brothers who are outside, there is a space inside, can you just come inside, Jazakumullah Khairan. Come inside, Jazakumullah Khairan, there is a space in the back.
We started lying, we cannot fill up the first one.
Atimu al-sufuh, finish the lines, al-awwal of al-awwal, my dear brothers, inshallah. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. والعاديات ضبحا فالموريات قدحا فالمغيرات صبحا فآثرن به نقعا فوسطن به جمعا إن الإنسان لربه لكنود وإنه على ذلك لشهيد وإنه لحب الخير لشديد أفلا يعلم إذا بعثر ما في القبور وحصل ما في الصدور إن ربهم بهم يومئذ لخبير. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. الله أكبر.